Wrestling Rampage here, back with another video.
That's right, we are back with another video. This is Wrestling Rampage. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, facebook.com/WrestlingRampage2. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter, @WrestleRampage. Hit that subscribe button. Because what, Tommy?
Got plenty more great fucking videos.
That's
for you.
Right. We got some. We do got some great videos coming
out. That's right.
For
our subscribers too.
That's right, for our subscribers. And don't forget, here soon, and we're going to be doing a video on this. We're going to show how we do give back to our subscribers.
That's right.
Here soon. So make sure you guys come back for that. This is 5 questions with Wrestling Rampage, which are questions sent to you.
Written by you.
Yeah, that's right. Written by you, sent to us, either through our Facebook, facebook.com/WrestlingRampage2.
Or Twitter.
On our Twitter, @WrestleRampage, in the comments below. You guys can get in contact with us. Ask us any questions you guys want to, so it's not fucking stupid.
Because I ain't answering no stupid questions.
You know, we're not Gemini 888 here. We're not gonna be dodging questions.
Yeah, we ain't no duck dodger. We answer questions, but I ain't answering no stupid questions.
I'm talking
about dumb questions.
These are questions sent by you guys, and you guys can send us more questions, and we'll be glad to do another 5 questions.
It doesn't even have to do anything about Raph. It can be about one of us, you know.
One of these questions is not wrestling related. So, feel free. I mean, if you guys want to know us any better, you guys can ask us some questions.
Go ahead.
First question. Why does John Cena get everything? He comes back from filming the American Grit, or whatever it's fucking called.
Yeah, that's what I don't get. He comes waltzing in. to SmackDown
Live.
Like
he's Tom Brady.
Like he's fucking Tom Brady or something. He jogs in like, I'm getting a world title shot now. All because you walked in the fucking door, you think you deserve a world title shot? No, motherfucker.
You'll wait.
Nah, motherfucker, we're going to put you in something so you can earn your fucking title shot. You know, goddamn, put in a goddamn 6-pack challenge or fucking, you know, grab 6 guys from SmackDown, put them in there, and the winner faces fucking AJ at the Rumble. You know, do something like that.
But no, Cena walks in and gets a title shot.
Cena with his fucking Pabst Blue Ribbon shirt walks in, waltzes in like he's fucking Tom Brady or something. And says, it's almost like Tom Brady, I want more money. You know, or something like that. But he deserves more money. Cena don't, because he don't show up all the time.
Why does he get these things?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Because
like,
he's supposed to be the boy of WWE.
I'm sorry, if I was in there and I've been on the road all the goddamn time, when am I going to get my title shot? Yeah, this motherfucker shows up out of the blue. He just got done filming The View. And he walks in and he gets a goddamn world title shot. Or fucking filming the Today Show. When he walks in and gets a goddamn world title shot.
He's another Hulk Hogan.
You know.
He,
it's almost like seeing Hulk Hogan walk in at WrestleMania 9, beat Yokozuna in 9 seconds. And fucking with the black eye. Yeah! You know, fuck you.
Cena gets everything because he's Cena. And listen. You better recognize.
Yeah, I'm just saying. You know
every company or every organization's got to have a poster child. Well, and the WWE seems the poster child.
I agree. Other people deserve a shot.
You know,
over.
I still like the idea. I said, put Cena and got in 6-pack challenge with other six. Put him in there with fucking all the other guys.
I'm ready for Bray Wyatt. You know. To be in the title picture.
Well, you know, I'm looking for Randy Orton and Bray Wyatt to get in the title picture. You see them. They're too busy fucking with Luke over here.
Fucking with Luke Harper.
Yeah. And to be honest, he's the one who fucks shit up for him.
That's what he looks like most of the time.
Yeah, I'd slap the goddamn beard off of him than me.
That's pretty much it, right?
That's pretty much it, in my opinion,
I'm telling you.
That's pretty much it for Cena.
Second question. Do you watch The Angry Video Game Nerd? If yes, what is your favorite episode?
I don't know who he is, so I can't answer this question.
Pops.
Don't know who he is. Never heard of him. I'm sorry.
I have heard of him before. He does a YouTube channel about video games and stuff like that. I have watched a few of his videos. Just because sometimes I'm, and they know this, I'm very limited with stuff that I can do. Because a lot of times I'm way busy. So, I've only watched a few videos of him. He's pretty decent. Especially if you're really into video games.
I'm not into video game watching.
Well, he does reviews and stuff on video games.
Oh, well. Someone watches someone play video games, I'm not too interested in
this type. I don't know him, but I don't discredit what he does.
Yeah, I ain't going to discredit him. It's just I've just never watched his
For what I can tell, he's pretty good.
I ain't knocking him. I ain't knocking nothing. I just don't.
Oh, well, no. I'm just saying.
I just haven't watched his YouTube.
Third question is, was the brand split in WWE a good idea or not?
Well, it was a good idea. And to be honest, it is a good idea.
Because you had a bunch of people that was sitting there in mid-card.
No, you had a bunch of people. You know, they have Raw and SmackDown. They didn't have the brand split. You had a lot of people sitting there eating unbooked catering. Am I going to be on Superstars or Main Event? Because I want something to do. No, you ain't gonna be on either. Well, I guess I'll continue eating the salad then.
Because they had the catering there and everything, and half the damn roster stayed back with catering and ate their food.
You know, I'm just saying. You know, like
it gives a lot of people more TV time, more opportunities.
But then there is a bad side to it. Because look at Raw. Raw is an atrocious. I'm telling you, Raw.
Chris Jericho and Kevin Owens.
Kevin Owens and Chris Jericho tried to save that show as much as they can, but they can't do it.
Like what they are, Chris Jericho and Kevin Owens are fucking the Olympic swimmer, fucking pulling everything to the forward. Hey, strap on the back. We're going to fucking dog paddle.
Yeah.
And what they're doing is they're fucking.
No, it's like fucking seeing fucking Baywatch. Okay. And you see, and you see the people in the water, right? In which that's all the Raw guys, right? And you see, here comes David Hasselhoff, which is Jericho and Owens and some other guy. You know, you see they're going, oh, we gotta save it, and then they come out, goddamn, he drowned. He's already there, down. Well, back out of the water now.
Yeah.
Now I'm just saying, Raw is just. Bad.
Like, was those episodes with Shawn Michaels and Vader and WCW?
No, it was so bad, Mike. When I watched, it was this fucking Titus O'Neil went to join the goddamn New Day. You're wasting valuable airtime with this motherfucker carrying a keg. This precious airtime, and you want to show Titus O'Neil carrying a keg. What the fuck does that gotta do? You know, they just put on shit that don't fucking matter. That fans know they don't give a fuck about. You know, let's put out Sin Cara and fucking Tony Nese out there. Or fucking, let's put fucking, we need some time. Okay, Darren, get out there.
Get him, Bob.
Darren and Bob go out there, you know.
Easy, Bob.
Yeah. Hey, we need a bad guy fuck Sin Gender out there.
Hinder gender.
You know, goddamn. I'm sorry, Raw is just atrocious.
Like people were pumped that Shawn Michaels and Undertaker were going to make a return. And I was sitting there like,
I can already plan Shawn Michaels and the Undertaker's return.
With my googly eyes.
There you go. You know.
Watch
Galvin Stone. Watch Galvin Stone.
He put me.
Hallelujah! Watch Galvin Stone.
super kick. Leave.
super kick on Rusev. With my fucking black cowboy hat, powder. Here comes the Undertaker. I won in the Royal Rumble. 29 souls, ditch digging. You know what the fuck that says? You know. Here we go. That's,
which is funny, you know. because if you remember back at Survivor Series,
29 souls digging holes or some shit.
If you remember, at Survivor Series, he's like, SmackDown's always going to be my home. What the fuck is he doing on Raw?
What the fuck he doing on Raw?
It makes zero sense.
You know, it's just
well, it's the WWE, people. It never does.
I did like what Baron Corbin said on Talking Smack.
Oh, yeah.
He goes, listen, The Undertaker can go ahead and dig his 29 holes because we always need ditch diggers.
I love that.
Which
Baron Corbin is the man.
I like his attitude. It's just, I don't think it's a great... I like Baron Corbin whatsoever.
I like everything about Baron Corbin. The fucking beanie, the fucking...
You wanna know why? Because you're a fucking dick like he is.
That's right.
Paulus, what do you think about the brand split?
Just like I said, you know,
I think overall it was good.
It was good. It's just...
And I do like Jericho, and I do like Kevin Owens, but to me, the one that put the hornets to trying to dig them out was the girls, and that's Charlotte and Sasha Banks. I'm sorry. They're the ones with the strap trying to pull them out. Well, they can't. It's over. It's done. They're getting buried themselves.
I'm sorry. I think SmackDown has a better product.
Overall, I think it was a good idea, but a lot of things suffered in the process.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's just me. I just think SmackDown has a better show.
They do.
In my opinion, if
Raw went back to 2 hours and cut out all the unnecessary bullshit.
Well, here's the thing. A lot of people saying, why you want Raw to 3 hours? And then they go, why you want Raw back to 2 hours? Well, to be honest, I think it don't even fucking matter because they're going to put in stupid shit any damn
day. Well, see, I'm hoping maybe if they cut out that last hour, maybe we can have some stuff in there that they can actually fit
into.
You
know, I'm sorry. Like, every time I watch Raw, I fall asleep. But once SmackDown comes on, I don't fall asleep. But every time, if it's Kevin Owens or Jericho, I'm interested. But then once here comes Roman Reigns or fucking Seth Rollins.
Hoo-ha!
Or, you know... And here's the thing, I used to like Seth Rollins. Now he's paired with Roman Reigns. I have no respect for you. Mr. Dick Pick.
Dick Pick. Since Dick Picks gets the WWE Championship.
No, just tell me.
Which says something for Tommy. Anybody that likes Roman Reigns, he don't like them. So they get it.
That's the truth.
And if there's Roman Reigns fans, fuck you.
Hey, we say what we gotta say on this channel.
We roll it.
Next question number 4 is: should the WWE Network? I laugh when I heard this fucking question.
Tell me this question.
Should the WWE Network have WWE's ECW?
Oh, hell no. Oh, no.
Look at Tony's face.
Look at this. Oh, God. That's just to tell you right then and there, right here.
Oh, God.
Oh, shit. Really?
Should have WWE ECW. Well, fuck, they got in fucking Nitro 2001, so I guess, you know. They got Nitro 2000 in 2001, you know.
Looks like it was blended in a mix. Yeah, mixmaster.
Yeah, you know. So.
Let's just be honest.
What was so good?
Yeah.
They had a few.
Name me one thing from ECW that stood out and became iconic.
Besides, like, CM Punk. And to be honest, he didn't come iconic.
Exactly.
But
he wasn't that iconic in ECW.
And you're saying they were bashing him, but like Vince was bashing him.
Well, Vince has always been bashing.
He bashes everybody, so, you know.
Well, see.
But here's the thing, you know. When I first watched the first episode of fucking ECW.
The zombie.
On fucking Sci-Fi.
With the zombie.
No, first, here comes the Sandman. I was like, okay, I can endure that, you know. Sandman, he's an ECW original. I guess I can handle that. But when I saw this fucking zombie come out, I was like, what the fuck is this shit? This ain't ECW. This is ECW fucking light. You know, and it was...
Which coined the phrase WWE's ECW.
You know, this ain't ECW. This is garbage, okay? They had a few good matches on there, you know.
Macho Libre.
Macho Libre. They bring out Tony DeVito as a pastor. They bring out fucking Big Dick fucking Shaggy Johnson. And fucking... And fucking don't forget that Braden Walker.
Braden Walker! Hall of Fame 2017. Yeah.
You know how long did he last? About 2 weeks? You know, it's just... I understand that they wanted to have some young guys, you know, make it like a developmental kind of...
But they had a developmental territory at that time.
Yeah, they did. They had OVW.
They had OVW once...
So why and do by you the way, need...
By the way, they did not put any money into OVW
so
whatsoever.
So why do you need ECW?
They didn't put no money
why
in
do you need
it,
a
but
third
they come down
brand.
There and robbed their talent.
But,
they did at the end.
Yeah, they did.
It was they just, took them all to Florida.
You know, it was awful. Like, that yeah. They had a few good matches at ECW. I remember the Big Show with Ric Flair. That was actually a pretty good match.
Yeah.
And they had...
I'm talking about, was there anything that, you know, was like, fuck yeah, this is what I want to see?
Yeah.
When they had don't that, say something stupid.
No, when they had that Batista and Big Show match and the fans were saying change the channel. You know, that was great, okay? Because it's telling you, they were in the Hammerstein Ballroom, too, to be exact. And that's an ECW fucking area when they were in ECW. The original ECW went to.
Mm-hmm.
And it was fucking great, okay? I laughed my ass off. And they were saying, you both suck. Okay, this is Big Show and Batista. These are WWE guys. This ain't fucking ECW guys. You know, Batista would never last in ECW. Give me a goddamn break.
Guardian of the
God. Goddamn, he could barely last in an OVW. What do you think he's going to last in ECW? You know, I'm just saying.
Would you watch it if they put it on the WWE Network?
Nope. I don't even watch 2000, 2001 Nitro. You think I'm going to watch it?
Sadly enough, I watched some of the 2001 pay-per-views. The pay-per-views aren't too bad, but the show itself, like Nitro and Thunder and Saturday Night.
Oh, my God. Atrocious.
I don't think they should... Actually, I think what WWE needs to do is grab everything that was ECW, WWE's ECW, throw it in a big garbage can, get JBL's little gimmick that he had on SmackDown,
yeah,
and light it on fire.
Yes, that was awful.
That's what I think they should do to those tapes.
Terrible.
Or put it in Kevin Dunn's fucking burning fucking trunk. I don't give
and
a
this
shit.
This time don't save it.
That's what I think they should do to WWE's ECW. Did they have a few good matches? Of course they're going to have some good matches.
They had some good matches. Like when Kurt Angle was there, he took on Rob Van Dam Sabu, but who else is he going to take on?
There was nobody else that was at that caliber at that point.
You know, who else is going to give Kurt Angle a challenge? You know, when he was in ECW, who? Steven Richards? You know, fucking Danny Doring? Give me a break.
But, I will say, you know, they had a few good matches on certain ECWs, and of course you got to see Kelly Kelly strip. But then
I'm
going to
call it stripping.
But of course...
And she has no rhythm.
I wouldn't call it stripping either. I call it kind of like pimping, but I wouldn't call it stripping.
And she has no rhythm either. And to me, I was like...
Well, let's just be honest. That was the only entertainment I've seen.
That's about it.
That was not even entertaining to me.
That's about it right there.
I was more interested in seeing Balls Mahoney's poker strip thing than fucking watch Kelly Kelly.
I forgot about that strip poker thing with Balls Mahoney.
Oh, my God. Oh,
well, point blank in the sentence, don't put that garbage on the WWE Network.
Please don't. You already put enough garbage on there. Fucking Nitro 2001. I don't need any more garbage on there as it is.
ECW 93.
Oh, God. Don't watch ECW 93, 94. Fucking.
Johnny Hotbody, baby.
God damn. Don't watch any of that shit.
Let's put it down. The originals are gone. It's done.
Fucking Rock and Rebel.
ECW. is gone,
but I will say this: there is one thing that I liked on WWE Network that I enjoyed that they did was that authentic story of ECW.
That was good.
Had Paul Heyman, Taz, Dudleys, Tommy Dreamer there, and they were talking about the ECW.
Corey Graves didn't know what fuck he was. Well, of course, because he's like,
well, you know,
ECW, huh? When was this?
Well, you know, you.
Yeah, I would love to slap. I'm sorry.
You had to have the guys there, the one that started it all, and because they're the one that knew everything about it. Mm-hmm. So you know, you had to have them.
Joey Styles in there.
Okay. Yeah.
You could hire him for one day and fucking do that shit.
Well, they're afraid he's gonna hit somebody.
Yeah.
Get some fuck.
Afraid he might get angry.
again. He just fucking knocked out JBL.
So, no, do not put that crap on the WWE Network. We already have enough crap on that WWE Network as it is.
Yeah.
And then the last and fifth question is, thoughts on Dolph Ziggler's heel turn?
Thoughts on Dolph Ziggler's heel turn?
Hmm? He ends up losing the Intercontinental title to Dean. And after that, it's been a downward spiral.
Well, he lost the Intercontinental to The Miz.
Well, The Miz, excuse me.
And then he kept jobbing out to Kalisto.
Uh-huh.
Jobbed out to Corbin, which mm-hmm. is rightfully so.
Yeah, to you.
Yeah. But Kalisto, I was like, that should be a Dolph match right there. Yeah. He should win that one.
And he lost, and then he just started like, beat the shit out of Kalisto
yeah,
with a chair.
Ah! 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 Ah!
Here comes Smiley
Creed. Here comes Apollo Creed.
You know,
and of course, and of course, he didn't do a goddamn thing.
Apollo Creed, same difference as the Miz.
And of course, he got him beat down.
Smiley Cruz comes in there. And
but I did enjoy what Dolph Ziggler told Jerry, though. You know, you keep messing with me, I'll give you another heart attack.
Yeah, what you think about that?
You
watched the segment.
Yeah,
and you
yeah I thought it was stupid.
But that super kick was the worst super kick.
Oh, yeah. Dolph did not put any oomph into it, and Jerry didn't sell it.
Yeah.
like Dolph hits him, Jerry, just cowers down.
This is...
You know.
But then again, that's what Jerry was
part,
doing in Memphis.
But the funniest part was seeing...
He no-sold it like he did back in Memphis days.
But the funniest part was seeing JBL trip over that cord.
And it's funny when he went back to commentary and David was like, oh, looks like you tripped there. Well, you didn't do nothing. That's what made me laugh.
JBL made me laugh. Well, I didn't see your ass getting up. And by the way, David will tell him that you're a dumb fuck, okay? You don't deserve to have a job. And the only reason you have that fucking job, because you and Byron Saxton are a lot alike. You both couldn't wrestle in the ring. You couldn't hack it. So you go... I'm gonna try my hand at commentating, and
well,
I suck
it's not
at that,
working.
And I suck at that too with my Harvard degree, you know, and my fucking shitty ass goddamn Speedway cup. Remember that cup he would always carry?
Yeah.
And fucking Byron Saxton. I haven't seen that motherfucker wrestle once, so it don't look like he had a career.
he didn't really have one.
You know, and Percy's up there too. He's another one that should go. You know, I'm sorry, you could find better announcers. Nigel McGuinness.
Yes.
Put him in there, because he actually did a good job.
With that UK tournament?
You know, he was really good. And by the way, it wasn't Michael Cole that was carrying that load. It was Nigel.
No, go back and watch the UK tournament. Michael Cole
fucked up a lot.
He fucked up a lot.
And Nigel covered him.
So
you need to thank goddamn Nigel McGuinness, okay? And to be honest, I think he should have a job fucking commentating. And to be honest, I think you should... And Tom Phillips is better than David Otunga, too. Why don't you take David Otunga completely out of there and just have JBL, Moro, and Tom? You know, you got four announcers. You know, you got four announcers on fucking SmackDown. You know, David Otunga is not needed.
Thoughts on Dolph Ziggler? He's terrible. He's getting off the subject.
All right. About Dolph Ziggler, I like the attitude. I like him being a heel. He was way better as a heel than a face anyway.
Yeah.
So I'm glad he's going back, but he needs to change them fucking tights. I'm tired of them fucking DZ crew tights or whatever the fuck he's wearing. But it's time. I'm glad he's getting a heel turn because he was way better as a heel.
Pops.
So.
Babyface heel just doesn't matter. His career's over anyway, in my opinion.
Because here's the thing, you were getting behind Ziggler, but they gave him too many chances.
He's fucked him up.
Hang on.
It's time to pass him.
Now I need to know. Are you getting off the ZZ train now?
Or is it just because he wanted what he did to the rapist Lawler?
Yeah, which one was it?
No, because I don't think that
Dolph Ziggler. That's a good way to get heat, though.
I don't think Dolph Ziggler can do it anymore. That's why I say, if he turns a baby face. Turns a heel, I don't think it's really going to help his career in.
I will say this, though. They did give him a good platform to turn heel because of that.
With Jerry's King's Court.
Jerry Lawler's King's Court, the whole heart attack thing. Being in Memphis by itself.
And the thing was, he showed it. He showed Jerry on video. And it looked like Jerry was kind of pissed off. But get over it, Jerry.
I think this will be good for Dolph's heel turn, but it's just what can he do?
Yeah, what's he going to do after that?
Yeah, what is he going to do to prepare himself to get into a bigger stage?
Because I already know he ain't winning the Royal Rumble. No. You know, I'm giving
I'm looking for one of the old fogies to win.
That's an embarrassment.
But actually, we got the little Rumble prediction video coming up. Come back and watch that. But that was 5 questions with Wrestling Rampage. Don't forget, if you guys want to ask us a question, you can do it on our Facebook, facebook.com/WrestlingRampage2. You can do it on our Twitter, @WrestleRampage. You can do it in the comments below. And we'll do another 5 questions when we get the 5 questions.
That's right.
Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, because any questions that we do get in, we will do. So your question will be answered. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, because Wrestling Rampage is the cream that rises to the top.
Cream of the crop.
And nobody does it better. Everyone, have a good day.